Okay, hands up. Who here is bored to tears by Dungeon Hack? It's okay. I hear you. Kids today just don't have the attention span for a game like that. So, in order to appease you, I will be playing another game at the same time. This is a game that I own for the Genesis that is surprisingly good. It's called Escape from Mars, starring Taz. Check our options here. Our only options are controller options, so let's go ahead and start the game. We're treated to a little cutscene at the beginning with the story. There's Marvin the Martian. He needs at least one rare Earth creature for his intergalactic zoo. And what creature does he choose? Why, the Tasmanian Devil, of course. I don't really know why he chose that one. I mean, it's not, you know, the rarest animal on the planet or anything. It's actually kind of surprising that a Looney Tunes game would be as good as this one is. Because, you know, most licensed games are complete and utter crap. This one's actually pretty good. I really like the production quality for the art and the animation and stuff. Some of the music's pretty catchy, too. Alright, we are locked in this, you know, in the zoo, in the prison. But luckily, they didn't count on the Tasmanian Devil's patented spin. And burst through these weak walls. Taz has two basic moves, jump and spin. Come on. And, yes, the spin is relatively hard to control. I mean, when you spin, you go really fast, and it's a bit hard to control the direction. This is actually a fairly challenging game. I'm probably going to die a few times. And there's food laying around all over the place. I ate a box of rocks earlier, which allows me to spit rocks at people. We're pretty much invincible to most regular enemies when we're spinning. The only things we have to watch out for are things with spikes on them and things that shoot projectiles. Okay, we walk through a shrink ray, which leaves us pretty vulnerable. Our spin doesn't protect us from monsters, and our jump is gimped severely, but it allows us in tiny spaces like this. Ow! I'm not really sure what this shrink ray is for. I don't know, can I go up here? There's gotta be something good up here. You bastard. Maybe I can just get there as regular Taz. There's something good. A cake, some fruit, and a 1-up. How do I get in there? It's gotta be a secret passage somewhere. I could have sworn it was right here on the right hand side. I don't know, maybe not. Oh, there we go. I destroyed my fruit, but I still have my 1-up and my cake. This is delicious cake. You must eat it. So yeah, like I was saying, I'm really impressed with the animation and the art direction in this game. I mean, they did a really good job of making it look like a cartoon. I mean, the sprites are expressive. You know, when Taz is just standing around, he's not just standing there, he's looking around, and his facial expression changes. And of course, when you're a kid, the ultimate goal is, you know, you want a cartoon that you can play with. An interactive cartoon. when I first discovered the game Dragon's Lair, the CD-ROM game, you know, I was ecstatic because, you know, for a kid, that's the dream. It's like, oh my god, it's a cartoon with full voice acting, full motion video. Oh, how I did learn. Pretty much every game ever made in the Dragon Slayer series, Dragon's Lair, is terrible. I ate a can of gas, which means I can now spit fire at people. Spit fire and apple butter. Which is pretty useful around here. Around these parts. Man, this is one inconvenient zoo. If I was visiting Mars, I would be pissed off at how hard it is to get around. Oh well, I guess that's enough for now. Enough looking around. Oh, and of course to leave the area, we just have to eat the exit sign. Ah, platforms. This is now a true platforming game. I love 2D platformers, in case you couldn't tell. They're probably one of my favorite genres of game. My favorite in the series? Yoshi's Island. I'd LP it, but I think like 3 people have already done so. And I was never good at like getting 100% in every level and stuff like that. I think the farthest I made it getting 100% is like World 4 before I gave up. Or I think it was the bonus level on World 3 that you get when you 100% everything. It was too hard for me. I couldn't beat it. So that's that. I think I still have the save for that somewhere. Maybe I should go back and try again. Ow! I love how all the sound effects for Taz, the voice samples and everything, are just increased, the pitch is just increased, what's the word? A scale. Everything's a pitch higher than normal when he's tiny. Somewhere around here there's something that'll make you grow. I don't think there's a grow ray, but there's like a potion or something like that. That's pretty cool because you can just walk. Oh, bullshit, I hit him. Because you can just walk through enemies. The heck is over here? I don't remember. Oh. Just a way back to the checkpoint. Screw you, bats. I thought I saw some food. Oh, crud. Yeah, there are bombs laying around everywhere, tempting you to eat them. But you don't want to eat those. They give you really bad indigestion. Like, we're talking up all night with a freaking entire tub of Malox. I don't think I'll be able to get past Mars in the first video. Just some fairly long levels. I have a couple minutes, so I might be able to make it. I think the boss is right after this. I think I may have gone the wrong way here. There are 2 teleporters there. Sandwich. Get in my belly, sandwich. I love watching Taz eat. He just looks so happy. Chickens. I wish I got that happy when I ate chicken. But my tongue doesn't like chicken. I try to tell it to like chicken, but it just doesn't listen. Good gravy, another checkpoint. How many freaking checkpoints are there in this level? That was like the 3rd one. Oh, and the exit's right here. Alright, I got a minute to beat the boss. Can I do it? Can I do it? I should be able to do it. Sounds like circus music. God, I love this alien, man. It's like some sort of hideous elephantine mushroom with a morning star for a trunk. And when its eyes pop out, that's when you're supposed to jump up and hit it. Come on. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm going to have to pause right before I beat the boss and actually beat him in the next update. That's sad. Oh well. This has been Duke of the Bump with Let's Play Taz and Escape from Mars. I hope you enjoyed it. Those of you who don't like Dungeon Hack, here you go. See you later.